66 points ahead and only 43 points on the table. It's less now.
Sixty-two. 65 69 74
At last, the defending champion managed in the spring a big break together. He'd now won two frames in a row. That left us three more to play in this session. Here's the next, number six, Terry Griffiths at the table. All the balls still there. No points yet.
1.
Strangely enough, Ted, the break that Terry made in the last frame came from a miss read after a bad safety shot from Terry. And again in this frame, Terry played an indifferent safety shot and Alex missed that red. So this is a second opening in two frames that Terry's got from two quite indifferent safety shots.
Len Ganley, the senior referee of the UK Championships this year, having difficulty there in placing that pink ball.
8.
We'll almost certainly take the red to the right-hand side of the table, I would think, to come onto the black.
14.
He decided that he could get onto it easier from the other red.
21. Twenty-five. 26.
Well, Rex, he means to make the frames all square.
27. Yes, this next red, not quite as easy as it looks
31.
On the picture because it's a fair way away.
28.
But that's the one that counts because he can get that red away from the black spot now. Come a little bit further than he would have liked to have done.
He's all right.
39. 40.
Well, Terry can just get himself into a winning position without disturbing the five reds near the pink. So he'll certainly want to get these two loose reds before opening those reds.
55. Harry Griffiths, 55.
Griffiths then follows his 80 break with a 55, starting to play like a symphony orchestra.
1.
Well, that was nicely played by Alex.
7. Fourteen.
He's now 34 21. Points behind, but there's plenty of balls there for him to win the frame.
22.
Well, he was a little bit short on that red, but it came to his advantage because he was able to split the other three reds and still retain position.
28, 29, 36. 37. 44. 45.
Well, this is an important shot now to get good position on the yellow.
And they're certainly not messing about 52. In this frame. Terry jumping off with a 55. Alex, 2 points ahead.
61. 66.
73. Well, Higgins really moving up a couple of gears there to lead 4-2. Let me quickly tell you what's happened in frame 7 so we can catch the last of the session. Higgins has won it by 63-1, so he leads 5-2. So the last frame of the session here in Preston Guildhall. Griffiths is on a break and the scores are absolutely level, 32 all.
Well, an extremely good red,
39.
And then black, and I think, again, just a trifle unfortunate to leave the cue ball lying right on the red.
Griffiths, 39.
7 points in it then, and 4 reds to go.
1.
And what a good shot that was, holding position on the black with a little cannon onto the other red.
17.
Now the problem of the last red.
24.
Hasn't gone far enough, so we'll be playing a safety shot.
24.
17 points ahead. All the colours out in the open. The most important ball on the table, the last red. And a chance for Terry Griffiths.
Seven.
Well, he's come a little bit too far on that, because he's got to get onto the blue in such a position to get onto the pink, because he does need the as far as the pink to win the game, and certainly we'll have a lot of trouble doing it now. Well, he'll probably have a go at this blue into the bottom right-hand corner pocket, bring the cue ball back up the table, give himself a chance for the pink into the centre.
Terry Griffiths, 14. Alex Higgins, 56. Terry Griffiths, 53.
This might be dangerous. And what a lovely blue from Alex Higgins. Perfectly controlled. Onto the pink. Terry Griffiths then made the mistake on the brown. Paid for it. And the afternoon session finishes with Alex Higgins leading 6-2.
Thank you very much, Ted Lowe, and that's taken us nicely to the end of our Tea Time with Snooker programme here on BBC Two. Nine more...
important part, you know, of our game and the circuit, and though we'll never be the best of friends, I think I don't like to see anybody playing bad, especially one of the top players.
Terry Griffiths, the defending Coral United Kingdom professional snooker champion, talking honestly today about the man he's meeting in the semi-final and the man he beat last year in the final, Alex Higgins.
He'll just play it slow, and I'm grateful for that, because, like, I'm quite prepared to sit and wait for any chances that do arise, and only the way I feel at the moment, if they do present themselves to me, I'll go and knock a 60 or 70 in, and he'll be down the long grass.
Well, Higgins, playing very carefully, started out this afternoon at 2:15, and he certainly had Griffiths in the long grass, because Higgins took the first three frames. And in fact, in the semi-final, the lineup here, as we can see, Higgins has gone ahead by 6-2, playing for the right to meet Jimmy White or Steve Davis. Let's join the first frame of the night, a vital one for Terry Griffiths, trying to claw his way back. It's Higgins to break off. Your commentators, Jim Meadowcroft and Clive Everton.
Well, that's certainly a mistake by Higgins, attempting to break the pack of reds, but at the same time bringing the white ball back into bulk. He can consider himself fairly fortunate that he's covered the red over the right-hand corner pocket.
Six. Seven. Twelve. 13.
Well, that was an excellent recovery shot there from Griffiths. Still a little unfortunate. He's finished quite straight on the blue.
19. Twenty-five. Twenty-six.
Griffiths could have done with an extra couple of inches on the cue ball there. He's left this straight instead of at a nice angle to get him back near his next red.
31. Thirty-nine.
Now Griffiths didn't want to take the cue ball into one of the reds near the top cushion. He wanted to go into the main cluster of reds just below the pink spot. But he caught one of the reds near the top cushion, and that has spoiled his position.
30.
Nevertheless, that's a useful start to the evening session for Griffiths. A good start, imperative for him, of course, trailing by four frames.
Has snookered on all of the reds. He's already got down to play the white ball onto the side and the top cushion, perhaps to escape on the red ball which is to the left of your picture.
Glancing blow required.
Ball stroke, 4, Terry Griffiths.
Now Griffiths is in position to clinch this opening frame of the evening.
Griffiths.
Well, that one's a bit of a turn-up, Clive. The black certainly did look in the centre pocket, but as we've seen this week, one or two that have just run around the jaws. And that, of course, at this situation has put Higgins back in with a great opportunity. It was quite a useful positional shot that Alex has played there. He's 15. Took care to quickly get the black ball back onto its spot.
21, 22. Alex Higgins, 28.
Well, Griffiths, I'm sure, heaved a sigh of relief when he saw Higgins miss that one. It looked as if it could be a repeat of the sixth frame this afternoon. Griffiths looked as if he was going to level the match at three frames all when he led 55-0. But Higgins then knocked the rest of the balls in with a break of 79 to go 4-2 ahead. Much too thick on that safety shot.
One.
8. Alex Higgins.
Well, there are a few chances being missed on both sides in this opening frame of the evening.
Terry Griffiths, 44. Alex Higgins, 36.
Higgins knows that if he wins it, he'll be within sight of the winning post. Griffiths knows that he's got to win it to get back into contention.
Griffiths has certainly got the white into quite a safe position there, because he's snookered Higgins on all three reds. Alex's problem is not only to hit the red ball, but to try to get the white into a safe position at the same time.
Second time that Higgins has given four away in attempting that glancing escape. Didn't want a full ball contact, of course, on the red. Wanted to just flick off it, and allowed just a little too much and missed the ball altogether.
This is the opening frame to this evening's session, and appears that both players have had many opportunities, or at least two or three each. And of course, Terry in this situation, I think, feeling the pinch just slightly, concentrated that time on not only potting the black but getting the right contact on the red, which was close to it, and in doing so missed the pot. Well, Terry certainly can't win this frame from this situation. His big problem is the final red, which is very close to the black. And as you can see from the camera angle, he's very, very straight on the pink.
Five.
7. Terry Griffiths, 7.
And the black will leave Higgins needing a snooker. Terry Griffiths, 10.
And that's enough. So Terry Griffiths has put the first of the night safely in the bag for him. Very important frame indeed, because he'd had a bad afternoon. We'll be back with the frames that decide which one of those two goes into the final. We'll be back at 11:20 with tonight Welshman Terry Griffiths raising just a bit of hope back home in the valleys. Hello again and welcome back to the Preston Guildhall for our final programme of the day, and a day which has seen the first of the semi-finals in the Coral United Kingdom Professional Snooker Championship. A semi-final played out between the two men who contested the final here 12 months ago. Terry Griffiths, the defending champion, up against Alex Higgins, trying to get into the final for the third time in a championship he's never won. But today Higgins had the best start. 6-2 by the lunch by the tea interval, but then Griffiths pulled one back. 6-3 was the score. Let's join the very next frame, the 10th, remember, 9 required to go into the final. The 10th frame, Higgins is trailing 5-35. Jim Meadowcroft and Clive Everton are commentating.
Well, that was the Higgins of old. A highly speculative attempt at a plant, quite at variance with the sober approach which has served him so well, not only today, but in his quarter-final against Tony Knowles. Not a good shot from Griffiths. Too hard wouldn't have been too bad, but too short as he was. He put himself under pressure.
Yes, it's amazing, Clive, really, how the situation of just toed and froed there in the space of a couple of shots. Terry looking as though he had the whole table at his disposal, and of course, potting the first red and missing the colour. There's still quite a bit of work to be done, actually, in this frame yet, because the pink ball is not too easy, having the red ball by the side, and of course the black has been tied up on the side cushion the best part of this frame.
One.
6. Seven.
Yes, Higgins deliberately left that angle on the red so that he could develop the other red into a potable position in the middle of the table.
Ten. Eleven. Sixteen. 17.
And with that red out of the way, the red by the pink will also go into the same pocket now. A bad time for Griffiths to make the two blunders that he has in this frame. If he could have just made sure of this frame, it would have reduced the gap to two.
Twenty-three. 27.
Finishing quite straight on the yellow, the positional shot for the final red is all important here.
33.
Into the lead, and I can't see Higgins failing now.
35. 38.
Just brown and blue still needed.
42. 47.
47. Griffiths missed his chance. Higgins took his. He increases his lead to 7 frames to 3.
Typical of the whole match, that frame. Just when Griffiths thought he was establishing a lead, Higgins pops in and steals it with a late break. So 7-3, he's ahead again here in the next. Small score, 8-4.
One.
Actually, Clive, Terry paid the penalty there for not playing a good enough positional shot. And in the situation he was in, he certainly had to play the red. It was on, but it made the shot
four.
Just that little bit more difficult, having to use the rest.
Five. Five, Alex Higgins.
Higgins needing two more frames to reach the UK final for the third time. It's a championship that he's never won.
And that was obviously a very risky shot that Alex attempted, but he felt that the pot was certainly on, having to play a little bit of right-hand side on the ball, misjudged the pot, and consequently let Griffiths in.
One. Nine. Terry Griffiths, nine.
Well, this is starting to look a bit of a collapse. That was a perfectly straightforward black from its spot.
Eight. Nine. 16. Twenty-four.
25. A very awkward bridge in there from Alex.
32.
Careful not to disturb the reds to the left of the picture.
32.
Useful, but not the decisive break that it looked as if it might develop into. Playing that, Higgins was careful to cover the red which is over the balk pocket.
Griffiths certainly attempted the pot from one red onto the other. Can Higgins see the first red? Well, he was faced with a situation whereby he must attempt the pot, but in doing so has got, again, too thick a contact and another opportunity for Terry.
Nine.
Now, can Griffiths stitch his form and touch together to win this frame from behind?
Terry Griffiths, nine.
Portrait of man struggling.
Ten.
Higgins leaving himself an angle here on the yellow ball to try, I'm sure, to knock the red ball into play. Well, he's certainly achieved that, but the angle on the pot into the centre pocket is very narrow indeed.
Alex Higgins, three.
In this situation, in this situation, the most sensible shot to play, I'm sure.
Higgins.
Increasing the difference to 32 points. Higgins awarded a free ball. I'm sure he would prefer to be able to pop the red because that would leave Griffiths needing a snooker.
Higgins looking at the possibility of taking black as his free ball there, which would count as a red. And he's obviously given it some thought that he could possibly knock the black onto the red, scoring 1 point, of course. It's certainly a very chancy shot to play at this stage.
Green ball.
And that means that Griffiths needs a snooker.
Enough for Higgins to go into a lead of 8-3. And now Griffiths in real trouble. 6 frames left, and the defending United Kingdom champion has got to win the lot. Thank you.
6. Terry Griffiths.
The cue ball left the bed of the table, but that's not a foul stroke. A jump shot is only a foul if the cue ball clears another ball. Diabolical kick as the cue ball met the red. It prevented the cue ball running on, but this is still all right.
Still quite a number of loose reds there on the edge of the so-called pack. I'm sure that if Terry can keep in good position here, can certainly accumulate enough points on the scoreboard, maybe enough to even clinch the frame from here.
39.
The side which Griffiths intended to apply to the cue ball to spin it off the top cushion didn't act, so he couldn't have applied it as he thought he did.
Griffiths, 47. Higgins.
Well, the cue ball was a little close to the side cushion, but I still expected Higgins to get that. Maybe that'll make him feel better. And although that red entered another pocket, something quite fundamental has happened to Griffiths' concentration that he should be missing pots of that nature.
Well, I can only think, Clive, that that is purely from the effect of Higgins' play, because Terry Griffiths certainly came out in fine form tonight. But trailing by 8 frames to 3, it's bound to have a psychological effect.
This is not easy, bridging over the yellow.
That looked a little bit like a game of marbles, really, but Higgins's intent there was to not only to pot the red in the left-hand corner pocket, but to disturb the black from the side cushion, bringing it out into play.
The man in command. Despite all the mistakes that he's made in this frame, that red now means that Griffiths has his opponent needing a snooker.
9. Sixteen and three.
Higgins concedes, but still leads by 8 frames to 4, 4 up with 5 to play.
So Terry Griffiths had pulled one back and desperately now trying to hang on to this United Kingdom title. But from what he'd seen in the rest of the day, he knew he had to make only one mistake to let Higgins in. And Higgins is in here in the 13th frame, 4-12.
Well, Terry Griffiths in all kinds of trouble here, not at present time finding the right pace in the table.
7.
Crowded house here at the Guildhall, Preston. Willing, Alex along. He's shown us a different side of his character in this particular championship. We've always known that he's a terrific putter and a terrific safety player. In this championship, he's put the two together.
Just a little bit out of position there, Alex, having to play into such a fine area to gain position onto a red ball in the corner, right-hand corner pocket. Not an easy break to compile this, all the red balls being in the natural part of the table, but both the blue and the black tied up. Going to concentrate on the pink ball.
He waited there to get his balance, very awkwardly placed.
30.
Once again, the cue ball is cleaned. Terry must be feeling that his crown is disappearing from the head. Thirty-five. Well, the break goes to 51. And as Jim Meadowcroft has just told you, the black and the blue have remained throughout in that position at the top cushion.
52.
The audience applaud. Great read from Alex Higgins, but that really has been typical of the way that he's played throughout the whole matches this week. His break building has been superb.
63. Alex Higgins.
And that's it, and Terry Griffiths is forced to give up his United Kingdom Championship. Alex Higgins, with some brilliant play today, playing the match as he planned it. He said, all I have to do is wait and pop in the odd 50 and 60 break, and Terry Griffiths could well be in the long grass. Higgins in the final of the United Kingdom Championship. Without any doubt, I was saying, a brilliant match he played, starting off this afternoon, and Terry Griffiths never recovered from being three frames down. Really, from that point, the writing was very much on the wall. So, Alex Higgins in the final. He will sit and watch tomorrow to see who he'll have to meet, either Steve Davis or Jimmy White. We'll be here with that match. We start tomorrow afternoon with the second quarter-final at 2 o'clock. But the news tonight is that Alex Higgins is certainly back, and both Davis and White know that if they face him, they could be in for a rare old battle in the final.